So we're still getting an error when we try to build this Red Wolf. However, in this case, it's really okay, and I'll show you why. It actually gets done making the recovery image, and what it can't do is, remember in Orange Fox how it made a flashable zip for you? That's what's not happening here. Something is wrong with the build in that it can't actually finish and make that flashable zip. But that's okay, because if we take a look in the out target product, we look at the land, the recovery image is completely built. So here's what's great. You can use Fastboot. You can use my kernel zip and just edit it for a recovery image instead, and use that to flash this to your phone. You can also use Flashify and a few other apps that are out there that you can do, as long as you have root permission on your phone. You can also just use Disk Destroyer with DD and copy it that way as well. So while it did not complete successfully to make the flashable zip package, it did finish building the recovery image, which you could put onto your phone, which is really great. So I would have liked to have seen it complete successfully, but there's definitely something wrong with the version of glibc and some problems there. Doing a little bit of research, some users are saying that this would be a good case for building the Red Fox, or excuse me, Red Wolf, with a newer version of Ubuntu. So we're using 14.04 because that's what we use per the AOSP website for building Android. It's still tested on long-term service 14.04, but there are newer versions of Ubuntu out there, and they say if you have a newer version, then this glibc will work properly. We did try to install the newer version of glibc, and we do actually have glibc XX 3.4.21 installed. It's just not properly linked and not properly working when we run this build. So that's kind of unfortunate, but it did actually make our recovery image, which is complete here, 26.5 megabytes, and it even says so here that it made the recovery image and that it's done. Here's where it's making it, and then here's where it's completed. So that part is done, but what has failed is actually making, is running this vendor Redwolf, which is right here, vendor Redwolf. Redwolf, this shared library that it's linking to right here, actually is what goes through and turns this into a flashable zip, much like we saw in Orange Fox. If we take a look at that, we see in our out folder here for the Mido, where it actually made a I had wiped that build, but if you go back and look at the Orange Fox builds there, you'll see that it actually made a flashable zip for us instead of us having to make our own flashable zip out of this recovery image. So like I said, you can still use Fastboot. If you need help with using Fastboot, I do have some videos on that, so be sure to check those out. You can also use Flashify or any root enabled app on your phone to put this into your recovery image, or you can use Disk Destroyer from the terminal command line from ADB. I don't think I have any videos on using Disk Destroyer, but do be careful with that one. They don't call it Disk Destroyer for no reason. And then also you can just go ahead and take it and put it into a zip like we did for our kernel zips. You can check out my 64-bit kernel modification where I'm making flashable zips out of the kernel's boot image. You would just edit it to be a recovery image instead of a boot image. So a couple of options right there, and hopefully that will be helpful for you as well.